The Situation Room with Will Blitzer, weekday afternoons at 4 Eastern on CNN.
This is where it all happened, as you've been telling folks, in a mall area, a theater outside a mall in Aurora, just to the east of downtown Denver. There's the mall over here. Here's the theater down here. And specifically, it was theater number 9 where the midnight premiere was underway. Take a look at these numbers up here. Around 1237, 1238, something like that. That is when there was a moment in the movie, which many people say was kind of loud, an action scene. One of your witnesses earlier said maybe not, maybe that was in another one. In any event, at that moment, they say, that is when they saw a man in black walk in wearing a bulletproof vest and a gas mask. They say he tossed a canister into the room, which began hissing and spraying what police suggest may have been tear gas or pepper spray. Witnesses say the man then shoots into the ceiling and then begins firing into the crowd. Police will later say that he had an AR-15 with him. This one's disassembled. You can see that. He also had a 12-gauge shotgun, and they'll say that he had a Glock 40 caliber handgun with him, and he was shooting a lot of rounds very fast, according to the police. 12:39. Hundreds of calls start pouring into police headquarters. Officers race to the theater. At 12:40, they arrive less than a minute after these calls started, and they find victims staggering out through the lobby. They start surrounding the theater, calling for more officers and ambulances. 12:42. Some witnesses say the gunman is still shooting. Officers call for gas masks so they can enter the theater. 12:46. At some point here, witnesses say inside, for some reason that they don't yet understand, the gunman simply stops shooting and walks right back out the exit that he came in through toward his car just outside, and that is where police grab him. Officials say he offers no resistance and is still carrying two of his weapons, having left one inside the theater. They say they also find a handgun inside his car, an additional one. They say in addition to all that, the vest and the gas mask that they said that he was wearing at the time, the suspect shown here at least, they say he was wearing a ballistic throat protector, a groin protector as well, and he was wearing black tactical gloves, presumably to hold the guns a little more securely. Simultaneously, other officers have now flooded into the theater that we were talking about earlier, and what they're finding is a scene of immense carnage, Wolf. At least 7 people are so badly wounded that they could not run at all. Some are children. Police say some cannot even be moved at this point. There's so much damage to them. People describe horrific wounds to people's heads, arms, legs, bodies. Some shots even appear to have penetrated the wall, injuring people in the next theater. 12:55, less than 20 minutes after all of this began, you can see what's happened next. They move on to see what else they can find out about this suspect at his apartment up here. Police have cordoned off the area. The suspect at this point has told them that he does not have anybody else working with him, that he was acting alone. Nevertheless, they seal off the entire mall area to question witnesses, and the ambulances are so overwhelmed, Wolf, that a number of the victims are being driven by the police themselves, some critically wounded, to hospitals trying to save their lives.